Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is Dorn284. And as you can see, did a little bit of work off camera. Kitties. I decided to go ahead and set up a little shop so that we wouldn't have to worry about a whole lot. Went and planted a lot of tree saplings, which was nice. I'll eventually make it so that the only way you're going to get up here is through a probably a water elevator that'll have a kink in it so that nothing can go through it that doesn't walk. Just making sure to grab another pick. I believe this time around we won't be starting off focusing mainly on not going back down there after last time. We won't be focusing mainly on equivalent exchange, but one of the things we are going to do is come over here and introduce ourselves at the village. See what it is they want versus what we got, which is nothing on us. Another interesting map with a lot of floating bits. Millionaire is actually a very interesting mod. It adds a lot of playthrough to the game. It actually adds a bit more story to it. Okay, thought that was a panther for a second. No, the ducky! Evil cat, keeping that. Let's see if we can find the headman's house, which looks like it's this one right here. Alright, this is the Gone Village. This is the one we'll be focusing on initially. Don't want to talk to her, I want to talk to him. So our status right now is a stranger. We've not done any trading whatsoever. We can't buy jack here. This is new. Interesting. We'll look more into that later. See, and they'll buy raw wood, cobblestone, stone, sandstone, iron ingots, and mud, cook bricks, and wool, oddly enough. Alright then. They're needing more mud bricks. So the first thing I shall do is go home and sleep. Because I am really not in the mood to be out here and almost die again. As you can see, they will actually sit there and thank you for coming to visit them. They have different little things they'll have in chat or in text above their head. One of the more famous ones is something about only a woman can build correctly. I don't recall it off the top of my head. Let's go ahead and make way up into our house right here. Do not like how fast it's getting dark. Taking that with me. There we go. Ignore me. Most of you probably are anyway, judging by the absolute lack of comments despite some of the views I've gotten. But no matter. I don't think it was a zombie, not a creeper that showed up. Yeah, ooh, there's several creepers down there, not going back down. Let's see, we'll grab one piece of cobblestone. Make one piece of that real quick and make some wool. This way we have a little bit of something to give them. Whoops, 3 blocks isn't much, but it's more than I got. So, let's see. I'm too easy as a weeder grown up, so I'm not going to bother going out and harvesting that. Aw, it's a baby kitty. We could feed it and tame it, but we don't have a medallion, so we're just going to kill it instead. Ow! 4 points of armor, and it's still doing 2.5 damage a hit. Nice. Wait, zombie? At least have the demons need to catch on fire. Or maybe not. Plenty of clay in the area. We'll probably do a little bit of the Red Power 2 stuff. Mind you, I have absolutely no idea how to use that. I've never went through and done any of it. So it'll be a nice, interesting learning experience where I'm using quite a bit of a wiki. Gathering ink so we can make ourselves a couple of different books. For which we'll need a feather. Hello, chicken. Thank you for the feather. Now then. I did mention one of the reasons I built over on the island by itself is the villagers will not build over water. This will keep them from going through and destroying my building and putting their own in its place. Not that mine's much to look at, but still, you don't... Now let's see, we're going to sell a little bit here. And very short, we're short 54 denier from getting a brick mill to be able to make our own mud bricks. Very unfortunate. Let's go ahead and throw that up there real quick. Now then, where are they making their mud bricks at? Not here. Not quite sure how to read some of these names so far. If you have a clue as to what that actually meant, let me know. It's a little baby kid who is playing, and because I cannot understand the language, I do not know what he just said. My character will get the ability to read that language eventually. Let's go ahead and collect this for him real fast. Well, I'd really like to be able to collect one of those. However, until they're done cooking out here in the sun, there's no point in grabbing one. He's being a nice gentleman and sitting the bricks back out to dry. Technically, we could go and start scavenging for some of the other buildings, but there's no point in scavenging from the buildings just to tick these people off. Let's see. There we are. See, they've got enough wood for planks. Mud bricks is one of the most, what's the word I'm looking for? It's one of the items that usually keeps them held back as long as it comes to building. Yes, yes, thank me, thank you. Go away. Now, we'll just let them finish gathering their bricks on their own. I do believe we'll go and do a little bit of mining real quick. I think what we'll go ahead and do is get some of the industrial craft stuff set up. Probably build us a nice little factory on top of this hill. Or maybe go ahead and just make a underground one just to be safe. When we get to the nuclear reactor, it will definitely be underground. Oops. Now, is there anything specifically you'd like to see me do first? Let me know. I believe I said that before. I do tend to repeat myself, and I guess you guys will just have to get used to that. If you don't let me know, I'll just go through with what I feel like at the moment, and everyone just has to be unhappy. Speaking of unhappy, hello, zombie. Oh, die, thank you. I'll take those. I'll take that for later use. Like I said, we're not going back down there, as tempting as that is. Oh, that was stupid. I'm going to use our old house as our mining shack, basically. Assuming I can't find anything down here that's interesting or worthwhile. Let's see, and I have no wood on me in order to make some more torches using that coal we just picked up. Now, coal is more valuable here, but there's so many different ways to make a make something to make diamonds. It's not even funny, and diamonds are not even the best items you can make around here. So, there we go. Knowing me, there's probably some sticks and stuff back upstairs in that chest that I didn't notice, but oh well. Yeah, it's just probably easier way to go around. However, this will take a lot less food, me just walking and falling down here. That's lovely. Some appetite for if and when we do forestry later. I've never actually messed with it either. And another dead end. Also lovely. And there we have our first ghost. That's one of the weaker ghosts. Died in evidently two hits. And dropped absolutely no gunpowder. Great. Just toss a torch right there to keep them from spawning again. And we'll go and explore this hole. You stay the heck over there. Thank you. Alright. Every cave in this area may end up being a dead end. At least a steel pickaxe for that. Go away. Go away. Go away. Alright. That'll work. This is like a bad running joke. That was some copper. We got some more nice ores. I don't like being where I can't see down the tunnel. Because knowing my luck, this is about the time a creeper would show up. I am the tiniest bit paranoid about that at this point. Admittedly, I didn't die in the last save. I got close several times. I've gotten down to half a heart here due to my love of evidently dancing in lava. Try not to fall in that hole. At the same time, we want to go look into where this comes out at. Oh. Well, that was a pain. We'll save that area down there for later. And we'll go this way. That was a lot simpler to deal with than I expected. Just glad they never made creepers travel in packs. That would have been absolutely horrifying. And no, that was not permission to start doing that for any of the Mojang guests that may potentially see this at some point. Another dead end. Lovely. We'll come back for the gems and the uranium later. A couple of rather friendly skeletons. Come back up here. We'll make them come to us. Yeah, that idea worked well. Things are there. Right, that's enough exploration for one day. I really have no intention of dying yet again. Not that I've died where y'all have seen it, but it's been a rather painful couple of days for me on a single player. And we're now out of food. Need to still make it all the way up there. Nothing for it but to go. Yes, I saw the skeleton. There's no need to shout about it in any comments. Those are more creature skeleton, and they're much more dangerous than zombies. Whoa, I heard an arrow being fired. Alright, now let's see what we got for food. There's more chicken. We have a single piece of coal. Go ahead and make ourselves a book. Or excuse me, not a book, a tome. There we are. Oh, a little bit long there. What's really interesting about this book is you can literally just go through and type out everything. It's the first two lines that are important, however. Well, first line, evidently, because the first line is the title of the book. You can mouse through and everything else. Rather interesting choice for what would... be the sound telling you can't do something. There we are. Perfectly valid notes 1 and 2. Now, the only thing we should have to worry about here is ghosts flying up to interact. But none of them should be able to detect us. Keyword there being should. Do not quote me on that. Alright, let's go ahead and get ourselves some more wheat planted. Now, with Thaumcraft, there's a way to make this stuff grow quite a bit faster, and there's also an item in Equivalent Exchange that'll make it grow quite a bit faster. However, I believe the one from Equivalent Exchange will require a large amount of, why are there two spots? Three spots. Lovely. What was I saying? Yes, I believe the one from Equivalent Exchange and Right. Alright, well, let me regather my thoughts once more. The item from equivalent exchange actually requires you to have a bone mill on you, I believe. So that's not the best thing in the world. Let's see. That being said, we do have some bone mill on us. So I'll go ahead and go out and... we have some bones, so we can turn that into bone mill and have that on us. So we'll go out here and flash some of this up real quick. Eventually, once we get both of these plots full, and these plots are both optimized, out of two 8x9 grids, only one spot will not grow wheat. We're actually using that to optimize the lighting for the torches. Now, let me see. I'll take that. They can go up there. Those up there. Do a quick torch repair. There, a little bit more food. One more quick nap, then we can go and do a little bit more cave exploration. One problem I do have with the more creature skeletons is they do not take damage from being in daylight. However, I can work around that. Go screw. Lovely. No. He said that Dorn cannot run when he needs to. Odd that we got some gunpowder for that. Maybe there were two of them. Oh well, I'll take what I can get. Hello, new friend. Now, as you can see, as we're attacking the more creatures, oh, hell no. Stopped it, all right. Yeah, we do not want werewolves hanging around our house. Put an end to that annoying noise. Oh, son of a gun. Sorry, trying to watch my language in case small children are watching this. However, I make no promises. That didn't hurt too bad. You shut up. Shut it. Out. Probably could have left alone, but why bother? Now, let's see. Throw a torch in there for some more light. And now we can go explore that new little area. There you went. Oh, this will be interesting. Didn't you just blow up? Uh-oh. Right. Do we have anything that can be used as a weapon on us? It's a little bit better than... Well. Yeah, the creeper actually did us a favor. We've been mistaken all these years, and they're just trying to kindly show us where all the nice ore is. Yeah, I'm not buying that either. Nope. Not going that way. Now, we should have enough ores, really, to get us started. So what I'm actually wondering is... Yep. Enjoy the torch. Time to go. I'm thinking we may want to go do some, Ah, there we are. I think we should all... We should go hunt for a, I can't remember what the thing's called. Sorry, I'm losing what's left of my mind at this point. We should go hunting for a swamp. Go away. Do not want to play with you right now. Yes, I'm jumpy. Stay the hell away. Just placing some more torches out here. Partially help these things, grow partially so that things do not spawn under them where they can do damage to me. There we are. There's a convenient place to quit if we needed one. Now let's see. Did not mean to do that. The area is a little bit smaller. Now then, we're going to need a wee bit more wood. I think we'll go ahead and gather up a good bit of this to go sell to the rather merry millionaire people. This will serve us a couple of different purposes. We should be able to buy one of the, my memory would quit playing tricks on me. We should be able to go and buy one of the brick molds, or maybe even a couple of them, which would be rather splendid. While we're heading that way, we can also make up our minds about what direction we feel like going and why I'm talking as if there's more than one of us that get to make this decision. I have no idea. You know what? Good enough. Now, let's see. We'll go get us a new sword. We'll get us a, That sucker blew up my way home. That's okay. We can make a new one. We'll go ahead and get a boat built real fast, then we're going to have to go find a swamp. It would seem there's one right over there. Lovely. Like I said, my memory is playing tricks on me at this point, so just ignore me. Make us a stone sword, and we'll carry our new, the wooden one with us just in case. Actually, we're going to make a stone halberd. We'll also be making a bow and arrow, because there is some stuff here I really just don't want to get that close to, unless absolutely forced. Come along. There you go. Make a fast stone halberd. There we are. And we'll just toss everything in here that we don't want to keep on us. That. We'll need that. Let's go ahead and grab the other arrows. And you know what? We're going to go ahead and keep the apples on us too, just in case. And that reminds me, let's go ahead and grab our fish, or not fish, chicken. My apologies. And as soon as I get my head out of my ass, I'll go through and make that boat we're going to need. I think I had one somewhere around here, but I can't remember where I put it. Probably find it on my way back. No. Oh, great. Mommy and Poppy both. No, screw all of you. I'm going this way. One thing I've come to love about single player is you do not have all the ridiculous problems with boats you do in multiplayer half the time. Do a little bit more hopping. Here we are. Now, there's one thing I did not mention about Millionaire. Somebody actually went through and made it so that if a creeper gets near the village, the creeper is despawned. Which is absolutely lovely. Wish somebody would have done that for I just remembered something I was forgetting. Let's go ahead and buy back one of those pieces of wood real quick. Well, two pieces really. Oh, where'd you go? There you are. Because we are going to need a tree tap. I would quit messing it up. That would be lovely, too. And it is getting dark again already. My, how time flies when you're dodging large lions that want to eat you. Shut up, cat. Now... It's one of those bloody trees. As long as the lines of despawn. What you just heard was the beginning of a transformation for a werewolf, which means we are going to be moving a lot faster at this point. Because I am not wanting to tangle with a werewolf after it's had a chance to shift. Watch it be up here with us. No. Excellent. That means down there. No. That means I don't know where it is, and that I like much less than knowing it's up here with me. Yeesh. There's the werewolf. Okay. We're going to sleep and it won't be a problem. We'll go ahead and end this here for today. And later on, when we do the next episode, we'll go and get started with collecting rubber trees. Have a good day, everyone.